Welcome to California. Okay, there's in the center of the frame a wooden A-frame structure. We're looking at it edge on. And that is a lower tram station for this mine. There were two tram towers, and that's one of them. The other one is connected to a similar looking tram station up there on the hillside to the upper tunnel. You can see the tailings there, the waste rock pile in the center of the frame. And off to the right, zooming in, you can see that upper tram tower. It was a very simple tram mechanism, one cable and two towers. And that's how they shuttled the ore down to the lower adit from this upper adit. And then eventually there's a road down here that connects up to all these mines. But we're headed first to the upper adit, and there's the waste rock pile. And we're kind of going cross country here. The road is no longer here. It's been washed away decades ago. And that's what we have to climb up to get there. And here's the shot looking around at the rugged territory that we're in. So here is a closer shot of that upper tram station. And like I said, you can see the cable's still in place after all these years. And it comes down to the lower tram station, which we're going to get to next. And that's right down there. So as I'm hiking up here, up this ravine on the mountainside, I noticed an artifact here, a big old barrel. And it says here, right on the left here, there's a some kind of metal valve with 1831M written on it. And I don't know what that means. There's a name on there. I just can't quite make out what that says. Maybe one of you has better eyesight can see what that says there. Something company. Anyway, but that's an old barrel. And right in front of me here is the cable for the tram. Okay, we made it to the upper tunnel here, and here's the ore cart tracks coming out onto the waste rock pile, and that kind of goes off there to the left, and then panning over here to the left, here's the entry to the upper tunnel that we're going to check out right now. So let's go in this upper tunnel and check it all out. The main thing they were mining here, what was reported, was fluorite. But we think maybe because of the erratic nature of the tunnels that that was just a cover and they were kind of just mining blindly looking for something, because these tunnels reportedly twist and turn all over the place and don't follow straight lines, almost as if the miners were trying to guess where to go and really didn't know what they were looking for. You can see the ore cart tracks curving around here to the right. Paul's already up ahead. And there we go. So Paul noticed here in the tunnel wall, this purple rock. We don't know if that's amethyst or tourmaline, but it's all over the place in here. It's, you can see it here in the overhead, and it's further down there where he is. It's all in the walls, but here's another shot of it. If anybody knows what that might be, leave a message in the comments, but it's definitely purple. Very interesting. And then we just came from the entrance, which is right there. You can see the ore cart tracks leading out there towards the daylight. So just inside the entrance, there's kind of what would have been a four-way intersection, but the tunnel only goes there to the right. We'll check that out in a minute. But Paul noticed right here in the tunnel wall this black and silver stuff. I hope that's coming out in the video. Sometimes the light can wash it out, but just a small section of that stuff right there. I don't know what that is. It's black and gray, black and silver, very shiny. But we're gonna go that way and follow the tracks to the right. Okay, so we'll continue on into the mine. See the ore cart tracks leading down here. There's a big timber up here. A couple timbers. Several timbers. And the track curves to the left. And that might be the end.
Is it really?
So this tunnel curves to the left and ends right here. And what they call, in mining terminology, when you reach the end of the tunnel, they call that the face. So there's the face of the mine. And then we turn around, and that's where we just came from. You can see the ore cart tracks, and we'll make our way back out. Big pack rat's nest here. You can see all the twigs and brambles and cactus burrs. It's drug in here. And then there's a shot looking back towards Paul and where the entrance is. Okay, we're starting our hike down to the lower tailings pile there you see off to the right. So it's kind of a steep hike from this upper tunnel, but that's where we're headed. So coming down here, we noticed a smaller waste rock pile, and there's two adits here, kind of on top of each other. And this lower adit, let's go check it out. There's some ore cart tracks in here. Yeah, there's ore cart tracks. Interesting. And this wraps around here. This pipe you see on the left, kind of suspended from the wire right there, that pipe would have been used for either, I think, water or steam for the drills. It always runs next to the tracks. There's some classic mine timbering. That trapezoid type arch. These dots are made by the miners, indicate how many loads of ore were taken out. They'd use a dot for each load of ore until they kept track. And looks like this might be the end. Yep, that's the end. Pack rat lives here, like in all mines. So heading back out, there's that trapezoid arch, classic mine timbering with some extra wood timbers stacked up on top. And we'll head back out. This is only about a 100-foot long tunnel. So there's one more tunnel here, the lowest one, which is reportedly 500 feet long, maybe 700, something like that. So let's go check that out. Okay, so we just came down from up there to the lowest portal, which is right here. It's got some erosion going on here. You can see how the hillside is sloughing off and coming down here on both sides and kind of filling this in. But we're going to go in here and check this out. Okay, I'm just halfway under the portico, and that's looking into the tunnel. It looks like it turns and kind of bears off to the left there. So that's where we're headed. So there's the entrance. We just came in, and right here, some interesting detail here. Here's some really old metal wiring that's frayed, but that piece right there looks like electrical wiring, cloth wrapped. I don't think that's fuse cord, because it's got that at the end. And then here on the timber, hanging up here, is another one of these metal devices that somebody else explained to me on another mine where I showed one of these inside the portal, what this was. I'll have to look it up, and I can't remember. I think it's some kind of measuring device, and you often find them hanging up right inside the portal of a mine, because that's where they use them. So I'll look that up and I'll put a caption in about what that was used for. But we're going to head down the tunnel. It's a pretty wide tunnel, maybe 7 feet tall, and that's where we're headed. So let's go check it out. No ore cart tracks in this mine. Oftentimes the tracks were removed and used at other nearby mines to save on money, or sometimes they were just scrapped. Now this mine, if I can remember, this tunnel is supposed to have a lot of twists and turns. It goes back about 700 feet, I think. And very unique in that regard, that it's very windy, almost as if they didn't know what they were looking for. So here's an intersection. This is probably a dead end. Oh, Paul's up here. This is not a dead end. Yeah, solid rock.
Yeah. A lot of purple stuff in here.
So this is a dead end here. So the main tunnel is that other branch. Let's go check it out.
I think right-hand rule.
Left. That's always a good rule.
Oh, yeah. Big old chunk of that stuff.
So we're gonna head to the left here.
Okay,
we're continuing down the main tunnel. Still pretty wide, pretty tall.
Some good stuff there.
Some wiring and timbers. So right there, you see 210. So we're 210 feet from the entrance. Does that sound about right?
Yeah, probably.
So here was supposed to be an intersection, but they stopped, but they kept going this way. Let's go check it out. Ore cart tracks, it looks like.
Yeah.
So there are some tracks in here.
Yeah,
some ore cart tracks here. We curve off to the right. And this is a dead end.
Yeah. Some of the purple stuff. I don't think that's what they were going for, but I don't know.
And then the tunnel continues that way. So right here is another one of those metal pieces with the four holes, like at the entrance. And I just realized those are used to join the tracks, the ore cart tracks together, like right there. But I still think a lot of mines have one hanging at the entrance. I've seen that a few times. And like that person might have said on that comment on an old video of mine, that they're using it as some kind of tool. I can't remember. I'll look it up and let you know. But yeah, so we're going to keep going this way and starting to get a lot of twists and turns. Turns here to the left. Okay, here's a little alcove off to the right. You can see the rock layers there, how they change. And then we pick up the ore cart tracks again, right here. Only one, and that curves off to the right, which is where we're headed. What's right here? This is probably a dead end. Yes, that's a dead end. So we'll keep going here. Somebody left a glove in here. can see more of the ore cart tracks. What's that?
The Where's Paul mine.
Oh, yeah. Oh, the Where's Paul mine.
Remember the sheet metal?
Oh.
At the end of that one?
Oh, that's right, yeah. You're right. Look at that old bag.
Yeah, I couldn't make out the writing on it. Pretty hot
and careless, man. And once again, we reached the end of the tunnel, which they referred to as the face. Yeah, these metal sheets up here by Paul on the left, we think maybe these might have been used when they were blasting. Somehow they used these maybe as a shield or reinforcement, I don't know, but they're always at the end of the tunnels where they stop blasting, so it might have something to do with blasting. So we're headed back out to the entrance, making our way back. Interesting rock there, kind of a, that's more of that purple stuff. We think that might be fluorite, but you can see a big vein of it right there. And then we're headed this way. So here's the lower tram tower, and it goes all the way up to where we were earlier, to the upper tram tower. And here are some foundations for what must have been a building or something here, concrete foundations. And there's the waste rock there in the distance, and we're headed back down that old road, which we did not bring up here. We probably should have, but we went to the upper tunnel first, so we kind of bushwhacked up the mountain. But we'll take that old road back. So here's looking at some of the mountainous countryside here, and we're starting to get some rain coming in. You can see the fog up there, and it's kind of sprinkling here, and it's really gotten a lot colder. So